Today's Tuesday Tech Review is the Amcrest Go 4K action camera. Now, is this a GoPro killer? Let's find out. Okay, so we've got the Amcrest Go 4K action camera, 60 megapixel video, 4K 60 FPS video, waterproof to 98 foot. Let's open this bad boy up, see what we've got. All right, inside, we've got the camera, waterproof case. We've got some Velcro and some straps. We've got a clip. We've got some sticky pads. We've got a 1/4-inch 20 adapter for tripods. We've got a couple mounts with sticky clips and a 1/4-inch 20 female adapter. We've got a bicycle mount. A micro USB cable. And a 90-degree adapter. Also instructions and junk plastic. What we've got here is the Amcrest 4K Ultra HD action camera. It's inside the waterproof case right now. So let's go ahead and take it out. It does have a locking mechanism here. Unsnap that, pull it out. Boom, there we go. Now, what do we have? It looks like an older model GoPro, similar to that of my GoPro Hero 3, which is also in a waterproof case, because that's the only way that these were waterproof when they came out. Now, initial thoughts on this, it does seem a little plasticky, a little bit cheaper than your GoPro quality. You've got your micro USB in, your HDMI out, and an SD slot. On the bottom, you've got your removable battery here. And that's pretty much it for features on the camera itself. We've got an OK button up on the top. And we've got a power and mode button on the side, on the front. And we also have a down and an up arrow button on the side here. And the top is the Wi-Fi button. And it's got a plastic screen on the back that is not touchscreen. So let's turn this on and look at it. Okay, so right off the bat here, it's recording 1080p at 30 FPS, and we can long press the OK button and it goes to a menu with camera, playback, settings, and back. And you have to use your arrow buttons on the side to make adjustments. So let's go to camera, we'll hit OK. We've got record, slow-mo, loop, time-lapse, snapshot, auto-snap, burst, and timer mode. Again, no touchscreen. In order to go back, you have to hit the mode button, long press, go to playback and replay the videos on the camera. And we can go to settings and change our recording resolution as well as some other settings. So here we can select OK. You'll see if we start at the top, we've got 4K 30, 4K 60, 4K 30, 2.7K 30, 1080 120, 1080 60, 1080 30, 720 240, 720 120, 720 60, and 720 30. So those are your recording resolutions off the bat there. I'm going to go back to 1080 30. We'll select OK. We've also got some additional settings in here, which are actually relatively nice to have. We've got some exposure options, some metering options, sharpness, video quality, ISO settings, time watermark, and record audio. Now, these settings are limited. Compared to a GoPro Hero 8, you're going to be limited in what you can do. For example, in the ISO, there is no ISO range. You just select the ISO in which you want to shoot, up to 6400. Your sharpness, you've got high, medium, and low. Metering modes, you've got center, spot, and matrix metering. And your exposure settings only go down by -1 or +1, whereas with the GoPro Hero 8, you've got a 0.5 step in that. So let's go back. We've got settings for flip image, some Wi-Fi options, Wi-Fi config, light source frequencies, LED indicators, auto sleep, auto power off, button volume, language, time format, and sync time, set date, format SD card, device info, factory reset. And then press OK to exit. So it does have your total time recorded and total time available to record. And if we take an SD card here, now I just have a cheap SD card from Micro Center. It is a class 10 SDXC memory card. We're going to pop that into the camera. And you can see now that that time has changed and the SD card is available. Now, let's take a look at the attachments that go with this. First is the case. Very similar to the GoPro Hero 3 case. There is no way to attach the camera without the case. Or in this instance, they give you this back clip, which has two 1/4-20 attachments, and you can slide the camera in. It hooks like that. You've got access to the back screen. You've got access to the front and all of your buttons. You can then take your 1/4-20 adapter and tighten it. Now you do have your attachment on the bottom without having the bulky case. This will help with the audio. In my testing, the audio is pretty lacking from this case. Now Amcrest did state that the audio is reduced from the case because it is fully sealed to waterproof the camera to 98 foot. The case itself is relatively well made. I do like the locking feature on the top. You can't pop that open. The seal around the side, it has a little left to be desired. This side seals relatively well. This side, not so much. Now, is that going to affect the waterproofing? Only time will tell. You do have spring reactive buttons on the sides here to push your buttons for your camera. Now, we also have the bicycle mount, which is fairly standard. There's not much to say about these. I will say that you are relatively limited on the size of handlebars that you can mount. This would not fit my road bike, but it could fit my mountain bike handlebars. So something to think about if you do go this route. The other pieces, you know, are really only going to work if you attach this quick buckle to this adapter. Now you've got a quick snap, and you can pop that in there. Secure attachment does not seem to be going anywhere. Not sure how well the adhesive is on these stickies. So you get what you pay for, just be aware of that. Now, in terms of video quality, I did take this on a road trip and shot in 1080p 30 on the road. It does not have image stabilization like the new GoPros. I think that's one feature that is really optimized by GoPro. Something that I tend to miss out on now when looking back at the video. You'll see that it doesn't quite have the stabilization. It's a little jerky at times, but all in all, in a 1080p 30, it actually is pretty decent. If you're going to shoot stationary from a tripod or from a gimbal, then this video camera may actually work fairly well for your needs. This came in at $59.99, and the question becomes, is that $59.99 enough to beat the GoPro? And I am going to have to say no. At this time, GoPro is, you know, the peak action camera in the Hero 8, soon to be Hero 9, being announced in 2 days. Is this something that, you know, you could use? Yes. If you have a kid who just wants to shoot video, for $59, this is great. This is something introductory that you don't mind if they're going to break it. It can probably handle a little bit of abuse, and the kid will have fun. You know, you can put it on a selfie stick, put it on a floaty. Any of the GoPro attachments do work with this, and let them have a good time. And that's my intentions with this, is to give it to my kid and let him run around and just film whatever his little heart desires. So that's it for today's Tech Review Tuesday. Overall, the camera is an action camera. It has some features that are nice that were not available in some of the lower end GoPros that you could use to create a better video. It does lack in some cases. One such case being the Wi-Fi connection to your smartphone. Took me about 3.5 hours to get it connected. So be aware of that. When you're in the Wi-Fi menu, if you're viewing from your phone, you cannot view from this back camera. So keep that in mind as well. For $59, though, it does have a niche market for a budget-friendly traveler or someone who wants to get a younger child into videography. Comparing it to the Hero 3, as I said earlier, very similar. I would save some money and pick up the Amcrest. All right, so that wraps up today's Tech Tip Tuesday. As always, hit subscribe and like this video to see more content. Every Tuesday, we'll be doing tech reviews and unboxings. Next Tuesday will be the Samsung Note 20 Ultra 5G. So stay tuned for that one. We've got some great tech coming up, some great reviews, and we've got some additional videos that you may be interested in seeing. So again, hit subscribe, hit the like button, comment below what tech you would like to see reviewed, and we'll see about putting it on the channel.